Love for God. Who made you?
God made me.
Who is God?
God is a supreme spirit who alone exists of himself and is infinite in all perfections. I am who am. This is from the Bible quote, Exodus 3, verse 14.
What is man?
Man is a person consisting of a mortal body and immortal spiritual soul.
Why did God make you?
God made me to know him, love him, and serve him in this world, and to be happy with him forever in the next, that is heaven.
To whose image and likeness did God make you?
God made me in his own image and likeness.
Is this likeness to God in your body or in your soul?
This likeness to God is chiefly in my soul.
How is your soul like to God?
My soul is like to God because it is a spirit. Therefore, it is immortal. Besides, God, like God, I am able to love and forgive, and God has given man dominion over creation.
What do you mean when you say that your soul is immortal?
When I say my soul is immortal, I mean that my soul can never die.
Why should you take care of your soul?
I must take most care of my soul. For Christ has said, what does it profit a man if he gains the whole world and suffers the loss of his own soul? It's a quote from Matthew 16:26.
What must you do to save your soul?
To save my soul, I must worship God by faith, hope, and charity. That is, I must place my trust and hope in him, and I must love him with my whole heart.
What is faith?
Faith is man's response to God. Faith is a supernatural gift of God which enables us to believe without doubting whatever God has revealed.
Why must you believe whatever God has revealed?
I must believe whatever God has revealed because God is the truth and can neither deceive or to be deceived.
How are you to know what God has revealed?
I am to know what God has revealed by the testimony, teaching and authority of the Catholic Church. Now we say a small prayer.
A very simple prayer. God, my loving Father, take from me everything and distance me from the Son and the Holy Spirit. God, my loving Father, give me everything that bring me closer to the Son and the Holy Spirit. God, my loving Father, beseech me from myself to give my whole self to the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. God the Father, Creator. Why is God called Almighty?
God is called Almighty because he can do all things. With God, all things are possible. This is the quote from Matthew chapter 19, verse 26.
Why is God called Creator of heaven and earth?
God is called Creator of heaven and earth because by his word he made heaven and earth and all things out of nothing by his word.
Has God any beginning?
No, God has no beginning. He always was, he is, and he always will be.
Where is God?
God is everywhere.
Does God know and see all things?
God knows and sees all things, even our most secret thoughts.
Has God any body?
God has no body. He is a supreme spirit. God the Son, however, became man and suffered for us. In his body, and rose again from the dead and is now seated at the right hand of the Father in heaven. He is a person also in the blessed sacrament of the altar.
How many gods are there?
There is only one God.
How many persons are there in God?
There are three persons in God: God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit.
Are these three persons three gods?
These three persons are not three gods. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit are all one and the same God.
What is the mystery of three persons in one God called?
The mystery of the three persons in one God is called the mystery of the Blessed Trinity.
What do you mean by mystery?
A mystery is a truth that we could not know by ourselves without God telling us. By prayer and meditation, we can always understand more better. Though we will never be able to fully penetrate the mind of God.
Is there any likeness to the Blessed Trinity in your soul?
There is this likeness to the Blessed Trinity in my soul, that as one in God, there are three persons, so in my own soul, there are three powers.
What are the three powers of your soul?
The three powers of my soul are my memory, my understanding, and my will.
God the Son, the Redeemer. Which person of the Blessed Trinity became man for us?
The second person of the Blessed Trinity became man for us.
Who is Jesus Christ?
Jesus Christ is the Son of God, second person of the Blessed Trinity. He is true God and a true man.
Is Jesus Christ truly God?
Yes, Jesus Christ is truly God.
Why is Jesus Christ truly God?
Jesus Christ is truly God because He has one and the same nature with God the Father.
Was Jesus Christ always God?
Yes, Jesus Christ was always God, begotten of the Father from all eternity.
Is Jesus Christ truly man?
Yes, Jesus Christ is truly man.
Why Jesus truly man?
Jesus Christ is truly man because He has a nature of man, having a body and soul like ours.
Was Jesus Christ always man?
Jesus Christ was not always man. He became man only from the time of His incarnation.
Is Jesus at the same time God and man?
Jesus is truly God and man at the same time. His actions are the actions of a human being, but at the same time, they have a divine, infinite value.
What do you mean by incarnation?
By incarnation, I mean that God the Son took Himself the nature of man. The world was made flesh. This is from the quote, John chapter 1, verse 14.
Is there only one person in Jesus Christ?
There is only one person in Jesus Christ, which is the person of God the Son.
Why did God the Son become man?
God the Father loved us so much that He sent Jesus to redeem us from sin and death and to teach us the way to heaven.
What does the holy name Jesus mean?
The holy name Jesus means the Savior.
What does the name Christ mean?
The name Christ means anointed.
Where is Jesus Christ?
As God, Jesus Christ is everywhere. As God made man with His risen body, He is in heaven and in the blessed sacrament on the altar.
Has Jesus Christ any father on earth?
Jesus Christ has no human father on earth. Saint Joseph was only His foster father in God's plan.
Where was Jesus born and died?
Jesus was born in a stable at Bethlehem and died on Mount Calvary on Good Friday.